नमस्कार, आभार, अभिनंदन, शुभम, तमन्ना, दीपक, इंद्रजीत, राधिका, एल्लरिगू नमस्कार। केम छो, हाउ आर यू? लॉन्ग टाइम, राइट? टुडे इज नेशनल स्पोर्ट्स डे, यू नो, बर्थडे ऑफ लीजेंडरी विजार्ड ऑफ हॉकी ध्यानचंद, राइट? सो हाउ आर वी? गुड इवनिंग हेमंत, हाउ आर वी? राइट? सो टुडे आई विल बी डूइंग विद आफ्टर पोरीफेरा सीलेंटेट एंड प्लैटिहेल्मिंथेस, राइट? गुड इवनिंग प्रिया। So what we have done, let us look into it. We have done basis of classification. We have talked about porifera, and today we will be dealing with, good evening Priya, Apeksha, Coelenterata, Platyhelminthes, Nemathelminthes, right? So today we will be talking about the coelenterates. And when I say coelenterates, the most important thing we should always remember, we are talking with a tube within a tube plan. And when we say tube within a tube plan, Maheshwari, Takshaini, are you Tamil, sir? Tamil terima. Kannada gotto. Hindi aati hai. I know English. पंजाबी दसो, ओके। सो बिफोर गोइंग इन डिटेल अबाउट सीलेंटेट, प्लैटिहेल्मिंथेस, नेमाथेल्मिंथेस, आई जस्ट वांटेड टू टेल यू द क्वेश्चन, मोस्ट ऑफ यू मेड इट रॉन्ग एंड समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सिमेट्रीज आर फाउंड इन एडल्ट सी एनीमोन? एंड यस, मोस्ट ऑफ यू हैव मार्क्ड बी। आई वॉज वेरी क्लियर हियर, adult sea anemone shows biradial. Why, sir? Because it has a slit mouth, so it becomes biradial. Mouth is like this, and as mouth is like that, so it has to have a bilateral symmetry. It cannot have a radius, it has a biradial symmetry, right? Now let us start the business for the day. When we say coelenterates, coelenterates means coelom, development based on the zooids, and it is divided into two: HSA, hydrozoa, cyphozoa, and anthozoa. Anthozoa is called as flowers of animal kingdom. Called as flowers of animal kingdom. Right? So these words will come again and again. I will not discuss here. I'll just go into the main crux of the things. So when we talk about cnidarians, do remember these cnidarians, you can talk about sea anemone, hydra, jellyfish, sea coral. Entire Australia is made up of this. Jellyfish, it is also called as Portuguese man of war. Divyansh, good evening. Portuguese man of war. Sea anemone, hydra, most commonly we have read from beginning. So most important thing, sir, what exactly it talks about? Cnidarians contribute only 0.6% of the total globe. And when I say 0.6% of the total globe, total whatever living component that are present, out of that only 0.6%, very less number, but they are the magicians of ocean. They are magicians of ocean. And as I said, yes, by default it has a radial symmetry, but sea anemone is an exception. 10,000 living species, it is both marine and freshwater. Hydra is a classical example of freshwater. Yeah, Deepak, Physalia, Portuguese man of war, jellyfish. Corals, jellyfish and anemones are in marine. This is the question that was asked in match the following. You find which is a statement which is incorrect about, and they have given, talked about hydra. Hydra is freshwater, do remember. And as I said, radial symmetry. Up till porifera, there was cellular grade of organization. Here, group of cells similar in structure, function and origin, they make it something called as tissue level of organization. Here you will get the tissues. And this body plan, as we say, it is a cylindrical body. And mouth is surrounded all around by a tentacles on an oral surface. Polyp, it is sessile, it does not move, it is fixed. Whereas medusa, it is free swimming, flattened, mouth down, virgin polyp. So you can see here, Jyotsna, I am fine, what about you? So you can see polyp, see the position of hairs. And when you see position of hairs, in polyp, they are on the upper side, whereas in medusa, it is towards the lower side. And polyp and medusa alternate in the life cycle. First time life cycle came in coelenterates. And when I say coelenterates, they have life cycle that is called as metagenesis. And metagenesis in animal kingdom is called as alternation of generation, or let me correct myself, alternation of generation in animal kingdom is called as metagenesis. Don't write metastasis. Very correct, Deepak. Yes. Polyp, as it is sessile, so it by default it is asexual, and medusa, it is free swimming, it is sexual. Almost internal structure of both of them are same. As I said, yes, you can see the detailed structure. This is the basic body plan of all mouth and anus, single opening. And if you see here, mouth and anus, single opening, medusa, this cavity is called as gastrovascular cavity. This is very common, very important. Here the cavity is called as gastrovascular cavity. Like we have a buccal cavity in our mouth, same way they have gastrovascular cavity. Outer layer epidermis, inner layer gastrodermis. Why, sir? Because it is surrounding gastrovascular cavity. As it is covering gastrovascular cavity, so it is called as gastrodermis. In between epidermis and gastrodermis, a jelly-like substance is there. Between two breads, you see a jam. That jelly-like substance is called as mesoglia. And it is surrounded all around by tentacles. As I told, single opening serves as both mouth and anus. Ring of tentacles on the oral surface. Most complex cell of animal kingdom, I repeat, most complex cell of animal kingdom is found in cnidarians, and for that only the name is given to them, that is cnidoblast, and that is the reason they are also called as cnidarians. Also called as nematoblast. Most complex cell of animal kingdom. Yeah, very correct. Nemoblast cell, Deepak. So if you see here, the first structure that you see, A, it is undischarged, closed, silent. Discharged nematocyst, when a netting thread is discharged, So you can see here, this is the nucleus of a nidoblast. Inside is nidoblast. It is surrounding, this tentacle is surrounding, which you can see a netting thread which is discharged. It is surrounded like this, a curved structure. Whenever prey comes, I'll just tell you the mechanism of it. All cnidarians are carnivorous. Tentacles capture and push the food into the mouth. Tentacles are armed with stinging cells. Sir, what are stinging cells? Stinging cells are the same cells which I am talking to you now. This stinging cells, when I say, nidoblast or nidocyte contain a stinging capsule called nematocyst. And if you see this structure, tentacles is stimulated with the pressure on the trigger. For example, this is the tentacle. Prey comes, it triggers. As it triggers, it is a lid like structure. This lid opens up. You can see here, this lid opens up. It has a needle like structure, which is a very pointed structure, and as it opens, nidocyte is discharged. This is the prey on which it surrounds, and as it is said, it is insectivorous, that is, it's carnivorous. And you see on tentacles, you can see these structures, discharged nidoblast. You can see here, it comes out. In nature, it is very precisely done. Precisely done. So before any prey should catch them or any predation should happen, they remove this sting. So as a result, they get chemoflage, they get away from the place. Nematocyst is a discharge, thread uncoils, entangles the prey. Some species produce toxins, injects toxin into the prey and paralyze it. And usually they say these toxins are neurotoxic in nature. Some colonial polyp forms have a medusa phase in their life cycle, that I told you, metastasis. And if you see here, specialized reproductive polyps produce tiny medusa by asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is exclusively by medusa. Earlier itself, when I showed you the structure of polyp and medusa, I have answered it. Produces a ciliated larva called as planula larva. It settles and develops into new polyp. And if you see this here, which is the blue color structure, that is haploid. Other structures are diploid. And if you see, this is the structure which is general. This is about ovalia. And if you see here, sexual reproduction releases sperm and egg. Fertilization happens. Zygote gives rise to planula larva, develops into polyp. Polyp matures. Asexual reproduction, budding happens, and in this there is a medusa too. Again, as I told you, based on zooids, zooids means gonads, medusa, which is sexual reproduction, releases the gametes, male gamete and the female gamete, make something called as metagenesis. What about jellyfish? When you say jellyfish, the story goes the same way. Separate sexes produce gametes. Egg separate, sperm separate. Fertilization occurs in gastrovascular cavity in female. Please do remember, this is the question that have been asked. Yes, ovalia shows sexual dimorphism. That's what I am telling Radhika. You can see here. Yeah. Occurs in female. Planula develops, it's free swimming. Planula settles, develops into polyp. Polyp produces new medusa by budding. So very simple direct question that was asked in Assertion and Reason once upon a time, ki how polyps are produced by phenomena of budding. We are talking about jellyfish, right? From here, let us move to flatworms. There are, when I say the second part of it, that is Platyhelminthes, flatworms. These flatworms, platy means flat, Helminth means worm. Hemant, any significance of metagenesis? First time in animal kingdom in in evolutionary tendencies, it has been told ki yes, polyp and medusas are responsible for continuous production of haploid and diploid structures, sexual and asexual. Only in evolution wise it has an immense significance, because everything, like for example, I am talking about flatworms here, excretory system first time started here, that is phloem cells. Same way, alternation of generation is started in coelenterates. Every phylum had an immense significance in evolution of human beings, which is the most evolved animal found on the earth. Right? People are getting it. Tamanna, Deepak, Radhika, Hemant, Indrajit, all of you are getting it. This Platyhelminthes, which is called as flatworm, is divided into four taxonomic groups based on body shape, mouth position and habitat. So it has, as I told, four groups or four classes. I'll go one by one. First is, sir, please provide us these all slides in the form of notes after each class ends. Okay, we will try. Hemant, nervous system technically did not start, otherwise nervous system started more precisely in annelids, nerve ring in earthworm, golden nerve ring. Nervous system technically did not start. Chemical signaling was there, which was not true nervous system. 3000 free living species, we are talking about this particular class. Some are commensal, and I hope when we do ecology we will come to know commensalism, amensalism and all. Few are parasitic forms, and do remember Platyhelminthes are, we will come back, aquatic, few on land. Body architecture is adapted to a free living lifestyle, right? This is turbid area, and you can see this structure, turbid area. Yeah, Deepak, it is a ganglia like. If you see second group, I don't know whether you have come across this class or not. First class was turbid area, do remember. Second class is monogena. What glutathione do in Hydra? Glutathione is responsible for regulating the budding and somersaulting in case of Hydra. Glutathione, very good. And glutathione is responsible for making a very important interaction, that is zooclorella. Zooclorella, production of an antibiotic. Monogenia, this is a very classical example, that is microcotyl. It has a two structures called as haptors. There are some 400 species, it's a new class. Mostly ectoparasite of fish and amphibians. They are found on the scales. Feed on blood and mucus, very important. If it enters into the system, the story is pathetic. Anterior and posterior end for clinging, but life cycle remains simple with a single free living larval stage. If you see here, because of these haptors, they cling to the fishes, and it's very tough to differentiate between whether they are true fishes or they are the haptors like structure which are to the fishes, right? And if you see here, this, when I say monogenia or when I do this, what you call it as monogenia, turbilaria, these are the different classes, right? And when I say these are the different classes, these have a very immense significance, not only for the establishment of that particular phylum, even for the particular evolution too. Is this glutathione only? Not always. Glutathione is not necessarily for always. And cladophora is an ectoparasite, yes, that is an algae, shubham, that is there. Cladophora is an algae, it has nothing to do here. Third class, that is, when I say third class, don't say. First class was turbellaria, second was monogyna, third is trematoda. Trematoda includes all the flukes. 6000 species of endoparasite. Do remember, monogenia, that was ectoparasite, trematoda is endoparasite. Liver, lungs, blood, muscles, body and life cycle adapted for a parasitic existence. This is the ventral sucker and this is the oral sucker. Very important, do remember. And best example is liver fluid. And when I say liver fluke, it is, anybody scientific name of liver fluke? Hepatic means liver, so name comes fasciola hepatica. The first class, when I told first class with you, it was turbellaria. Second class I told monogenia. Third one is trematoda. Fourth class is cestoda, that is important. Thank you Tamanna, thank you Deepak. Tapeworm. And classical example is tinea solium. And it causes a disease, tinnasus. species of endoparasite, almost all intestinal parasites have highly specialized body and life cycle. This is the real picture of a tinea solium. You can see it. And it is almost like an inchy tape. It does not have a segments. Do you remember? It does not have a segments. And the mouth is very peculiar, called as scolex. 9 feet, commonly tapeworm has been formed from, known from human host. Largest in the sperm whale, which was 30 meters long. This is average 1 meter. Do remember. Yeah, Deepak, correct. Tinea saginata is in cow beef. Very good. So, tapeworm, tineasis, scolex, when it enters into the human intestine, it is an endoparasite, and do remember, it starts feeding in the large intestine. Slowly it starts eating the wall of an intestine. And when it starts eating the wall of an intestine, it almost debugs it. And while sucking it, it makes a wound or an ulcer. And when I say it makes a wound or an ulcer, it leads to a disease called as colitis. Commonly it is called as colon cancer. By just this structure, if you see, this is the tapeworm, these are the four mouths, which is called as scolex. So it sucks very profusely. Do remember, it remains in the intestine. And almost it adapts the color of almost an intestine. So it's very tough to identify ki it's a mucus layer or it is a tinea solium. And for your kind information, tinea enters into your system by eating, very importantly, pork. partially or uncooked pig. Proglotted are the fragments which join together. When you say segment, it should be symmetrical. It is not symmetrical. Yes, they are 200 in number, correct. They are proglottids. They are the small fragments. This is, each is called as proglotted. And this culminates into a mouth-like structure. This is, it's like an inchy tape. This is used for measurement. Very important. Yes, sir, where to keep comb jellies, sponges in tree of animal life? What is the basis? So do remember, it is a huge debate today also. It's a very huge debate. Where to keep, right? Whether to keep before porifera, after porifera, that is not of your concern, but it has a huge significance in evolution, right? Now, coming to characteristic feature of Platyhelminthes. First, it has a bilateral symmetry. Because it is an inchy tape, it cannot have radial symmetry because it is an elongated structure. And as it is elongated structure, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, all the three distinct layers are formed in the course. If you remember germ layers, which I discussed with you in my first class of Animal Kingdom in classification, three germ layers are there, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, all three are found. That is triploblastic, as I told, it is unsegmented, acoelomate, it is a flat, so there is no coelom, so it is called as acoelomate, right? And if you see the structures, this is excretory, this is digestive, this is nervous, this is your triploblastic. And this is the detailed structure of body wall. As I told you, nerve cord, excretory system, this is the excretory system which has been detailed given here, mesoderm, epidermis, muscle fiber, because it has to shrunk, so muscles are needed, first time muscle fiber have come here. And if you see here, this structure is called as flame cell, because when it is moving with the guts of a water, if it moves, yes Tamanna, all of them are parasitic, yes, by default, all of them, you can write it, yes, whether ectoparasite or endoparasite, by default all of them are parasitic. When it moves, it looks like a fire is there, sorry, flame is there, that's why it is called as flame cells. If you see this structure, it is coming like this. So it looks like a flame, flow of water and waste, and this is how the flame cells look like, and that too within the body, living system, it looks like red color, so it looks like all flame is coming up. And if you see nervous system, brain is there, digestive tract, pharynx, mouth, nerve cord is there, but brain is underdeveloped and digestive system is very clear. And if you see here, this is structure. This is structure. So this is mouth. So almost the structure is like this for the digestive system. You can see here. This is the structure of digestive system. Sir, all the flatworm classes, now we call it as neodermata, but it is nothing to be accepted for neodermata. Yeah, evolving eye of a planaria, very correct Deepak. Eye spot is a sensory structure. First time a rudimentary sensory structure has come here. Yes, parasitic group considered to be monophyletic and constitute a group known as neodermata. And another is called a snapomorphis. New skin obligate parasitism, protonephridia from two cells. Nephridia means for excretory system. no synapomorphies for the phylum thought to be polyphyletic. Nothing has evolved from a multi-domain. As nothing has evolved from a multi-domain, so polyphyletic is becomes a very big question. And when I say polyphyletic becomes a question, so most accepted is Monogyna, Cestoda, Trematoda and Turbellaria. And if you see in this, all of them have neodermatic origin, nothing to do with polyphyletic, all have evolved from a single origin. Let planaria be free living, doesn't make a difference, but up to a certain stage, after that it becomes sessile, Hemant. And if you see, as I told you, body is in segments called proglottid, forms behind the small head and continue to grow until released. Mouth digestive system is lacking. Please do remember this, I am talking with respect to Trinus oleum. Digestive system lacking. Scolex attachment structure, tegument highly folded with microvillar extension, hermaphrodite. And if you see here, relatively simple, passive dispersal, reproduction is primarily sexual, right? And if you see this structure here, you can see here the pork and the beef tapeworm of humans, they have been fed. Humans are infected when they ingest a cysticercus in a raw or undercooked pork or a beef. Do remember, at which stage? Underline this, this is important. Cysticercus stage. Yes, it is harmful to fishes. Deepak or Hemant. Perfect, yes. Planaria larva is harmful to the fishes. Yes. And when this product comes, so let me go from beginning. From the humans, cysticercus grows into an adult sexually reproducing tapeworm in the small intestine, where it causes colitis. Eggs or proglottid containing eggs are passed in the host feces. Eggs are ingested by an appropriate intermediate host. Pig or the pork, tapeworm cattle for the beef tapeworm. So parasitological resource is either the beef or the pig. From there, human can be infected by cysticeri of Trinus oleum, and that's the reason when cysticercus stage enter into the host machinery from the Trinus oleum, it is called as cysticercosis. This is the initial stage. This makes oncosphere, egg hatches in the small intestine and the larva within the migrates to the muscles and grows into the cysticercus. Until it starts reproducing, it remains there, right? And yes, it causes cysticercosis. Eaten goes by the beef or the pig, and so see, this system continues. The most infectious stage is cysticercus. Cysticercus is the term that will be used here, do remember it. Coming to liver fluke, Trematoda, as I told you, Fasciola hepatica. It is very common in China, Korea, Japan. When I say this, I never mean to say it is not found in India, where practice of eating uncooked fish is common. Adults live in the liver and bile passage. Now they don't give you option liver, they give you bile passage, and most of us make it wrong. Yes, Hemant, what you correct, primary host is man, secondary host is pig. So what happens here is, adult eating the raw fish, egg in the feces. This egg contains a larva called as miracidium larva. Here larvas are important. This miracidium larva develops into sporocyst. This sporocyst grows into radial larva. From radial larva, it moves to cercaria. From cercaria, it moves to metasarcaria. Please don't change the sequence. First is Miracidium larva, second is Sporosis, third is Rhydia, fourth is Sarcaria, fifth is Metasarcaria. So it's very easy way to remember it. You can remember. You can always remember. This is like this. Mishramik. You give me shramik. Shramik means labor. Mishramik. And if you see here, detailed version of it is given here. As you see here, second host is fishes, final host is man, first intermediate host is snail. So in this there are three: first intermediate host, second intermediate host, and the final host. That there is a twist, do remember it. And here if you see, number is very clearly mentioned here. If you start from first, in the feces, in the urine, diagnostic stages are found. From here, hag hatches, releasing Miracidia. Miracidia enters into snail. As it enters into the snail, it releases sporocyst. This sporocyst through a radial larva releases Sarcaria. This Sarcaria penetrates into the skin, and as it penetrates into the skin, it causes Schistosomiasis. Schistosomiasis is a partially developed stage which grows into an adult. Circulation migrates, matures, and here, if I make, I think, yeah, it makes a psychostome. Several ways, it is dioecious. It almost migrates, psychostome type. Right, and it stays in the vinaxis of a bladder. Vinaxis of a bladder. Do remember. Right. Schistosome causes schistosomiasis. A very common disease. Schistosoma is hermaphrodite, Deepak. Yes. Separate sexes. Dioecious. Sorry, psychostoma is not hermaphrodite. Sorry, Deepak. It is dioecious. Hermaphrodite, no. It is dioecious. Male and female are separate. And you see in the same diagram, male and female, both are very happy. Right? So now coming to the problem, which was from the previous contest question. Chikungunya spreads through the bite of, I think many of you have answered. The person who answered first was Hemant. So Hemant, congratulations, you have been bestowed with one atom session, right? So now today's question, 30 seconds will be given. And the question is, horny layer covering the stem of various colonial coelenterates are, time given is 30 seconds. Horny layer covering the stem of a various colonial coelenterates. I know this question is a little complicated. This question directly I have picked it from Ames. This question directly I have picked it from Ames. What is not present in CBSE textbook, Preeti? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes, Deepak. Present in the same body while sexual act. It is not present in the same body actually. It resembles like, but it is not. It resembles like, it is present in the same body, it is not present in the same body. Okay. So I need maximum people should answer this. So coming to, yes, why people don't answer so rigorously? I don't know, only few people always write. I don't know. I dig a question because I know people are very intelligent, so I always try my level best to give you very complex question. I never meant to say I want to give you tough question. So, right? Coming to nematodes, technically they are called as hookworms, not bookworms. Right? My friends, I want to tell you one thing. Don't be panic for the things, okay? You people are great, believe me. The way you people answer, particularly whom I am in regular touch or interact with you here. Tamanna, Radhika, Shubham, Takshaini, Indraji, Deepak, Hemant, Ganesh. If I don't remember their names, with utmost submission, Preeti. All of you. You people are very great students. Believe me, man. Believe me. Smarnika, Kaya. I know you people answer. So always I make it, I don't want to give you very simple questions. All of you are very great. Please, any problem, come back to us. We are there for you. Don't worry. You people are fantabulous students, believe me. I enjoy with you people. I wait for, yes, I have to interact with them. I wait for you people. It is only two complex, Tamanna, it is not four complex. So, if I give you simple things, I know you people are great. So, I have to dig some tricky question and come back to you. Right? So, talking about hookworms, examples of hookworms are trichina worm, pinworm. This is very important. Phylaria. Phylaria, scientific name is Wuchuraria. For that, Wuchuraria. And entire group is studied. Entire group is studied because of this. Wuchuraria bancrofti. Takshaini, it is other way actually. Bachche Bhagwan hote hain. Oh, Ganesh, good. Superb question, sir. Good, good. I am blessed to have you, believe me. I always appreciate that. Phylaria, Wuchuraria, bancrofti. And do remember, there is no cure for this. And more than the animal kingdom, the nematodes hamper. These nematodes hamper the plants, and in plants they cause a nematodal diseases, very common, right? Deepak, Ganesh, tum kahan the bhai? Ganpati Baba laddu kha rahe the, Ganesh Baba laddu kha rahe the, isliye abhi aaye nahi wo. Good, okay. When you read this root knot in any plant, root knot diseases, usually root knot diseases are found in vegetables. These root knot is by nematodes, hookworms, by hookworms, right? Yes, Hemant, Wuchuraria is viviparous, eye worm, guinea worms. If you see the characteristic features, it does not have any unique thing about it, which is very different. Nematodes are thread-like, they are dioecious. First time tube within a tube plant comes, always move in S motion, and that is the reason these, if you see butcher area, they always attack in the lymph region or the fleshy region, and the medicine that is available is heterazan. 21 days course it is, you have to take after every 6 months. Single passage, yes. Butcher area is monogenetic, Deepak. Perfectly, man. I don't know. Today Deepak is very active. I'm so happy about it. Good man. Full marks to you. I don't know what happened to certain people. Even today, Takshaini is dull, Tamanna is dull. Indrajit hardly answers, but he answers whenever he feels like. Priya is okay today. I don't know. Ganesh Baba has erupted today. Pseudo seal is present, do remember. Up till now you have read as acoelomate. Here it is pseudo coelomate. No segmentation, triploblastic, bilateral, this is all is common. No big deal. If you see tapeworm, tapeworm has incomplete digestive system. Here it is complete digestive system. Yes, very important, very good, Tamanna. Female is longer than male. Yes. Dog is dioecious, that way I remember, yes, here in, I think if I'm not wrong, in all the worms, when next class I will be doing roundworm with you, Ascaris, there also females are longer. By default, I think in the animal system, females are longer whenever sexual dimorphism is there. Right? So, end with what we have done. Coelenterates, Platyhelminthes, Nemathelminthes. So, by default, match the following can be asked. Disease can be asked. Larvas can be asked. So, all of you, hope you enjoyed it. Yes? So, see you soon, next class. Till then, take care of your good health. Shubh Ratri, Shabba Khair.